gentlemen, I've just been told we've got in excess of 300 at this meeting tonight. I'd like to introduce myself. I'm Stan, I chair Broughty Ferry Community Council, and tonight we've had to move our meeting from a normal place in the library, which only holds about 60 people. We did not expect anything like the numbers. We know there's a very strong feeling in the ferry about trying to push you into East Ward, and I'm lucky I sit on the right side of Claypot Road, so I'm all right.
I was the councillor that tried to move an amendment that would have retained the ferry ward as it exists currently, but unfortunately, for whatever reason, and I'm sure Councillor Gill will explain, I didn't get any support on my amendment.
At the moment, Broughty Ferry is the largest ward in the area of the eight wards in Dundee. It's also the largest, or the second largest, in terms of population. Since I first became a councillor in a by-election way back in December 1984, there has been a tremendous population growth in Broughty Ferry Ward. And there's nothing new in boundary changes. There's nothing new in boundary changes. And these boundary changes are never carved in stone. And perhaps in a few years' time, we'll be back debating yet another boundary change.
In relation to the proposals for the boundary changes, the proposal that came from the Chief Executive was one which fitted in with the proposal from the Boundary Commission. It seemed to me that was a compromise. I wasn't very happy with it, but as you've heard tonight, the Boundary Commission are independent of the Council, and they start by looking at population. And where I agree with some other councillors on the City Council is that, in effect, Broughty Ferry is suffering from its own success in terms of its population growth. I think in the future there will be changes because the Western Gateway is the big expansion area for the future.
I'm not really going to add too much to really what Councillor Gill said, although it's quite disappointing that Councillor Bidwell on the night didn't support Bailey Scott, but in retrospect wished he had. He maybe should have done a bit more scrutiny before he made his decision. But I would say that this is not a political decision. I noticed he tried to say it was the SNP. This is about demographics, it's about equalising voting roles, it's about parity across the city. Now, the biggest decision is happening in Broughty Ferry, but it's not a political decision. It's a decision made, or a proposal, sorry, by the Boundary Commission. The Council put forward another proposal. I'm sure people in this room are putting forward proposals as we speak. It's not a done deal, and it's not a political decision. A decision was taken by the Council of all colours on the night.
There are a number of reasons why we looked for the choice that we made, which was to increase the area parity, the level of parity, and also to make sure that the new parts of the ward, which are the developing parts of the ward, which will continue to increase in future years, will be containable. As far as the committee meeting where this decision was made, I can assure you that 28 voted for the Council's position. This was not something which was sprung on people that night. The proposals had been there for some time before any meeting. The agenda is given out to all councillors 10 days before the meeting. So to suggest that you didn't have time in 10 days to think up an alternative, and that you voted along with the herd on the night because you thought you would lose, and that all of a sudden you've suddenly had the conversion of Saul on the road to Damascus, I think is pushing things just a wee bit. So what we did that night is we made a council decision. I am happy to stand by that council decision. and I will now be interested to hear what the other two councillors say.